estimated 22,000 plus women will be diagnosed with ovarian cancer this year. And so joining us this morning is Dr. Amanda Nichols-Fader. She is the director of the Kelly Gynecologic Oncology Service at Johns Hopkins Hospital. That is a mouthful, but you have more big words to say than I do this morning. Such an important topic to talk about. And of course, Angelina Jolie is out there front and center with her mastectomy and her future decisions. So
good morning, Jen.
Good morning.
Absolutely. Angelina Jolie's recent reported decision to have both of her breasts removed, as well as her future decision to have her ovaries and fallopian tubes removed as a measure to prevent both breast and ovarian cancer, really raises awareness of a very important women's health issue. And that is that while breast cancer is one of the most common female malignancies that women can develop in the U.S., and it's so important for women to know about what they can do to prevent their risk of developing breast cancer, it's equally important for women to understand all about the other female cancers. And we call those the GYN, or the below the belt female cancers, cervical, uterine, and we're here to talk about ovarian cancer today.
You say a lot of people don't understand that breast cancer and ovarian cancer are often tied.
That's absolutely right. And up to 10 to 15% of women, these cancers can be genetically linked. In families that carry a specific gene, it's the gene that Angelina Jolie carries, the BRCA gene, it stands for breast cancer susceptibility gene, can increase a woman's risk for breast cancer by up to 60 to 80% and of ovarian cancer to 25 to 40%.
We have some things for folks to look at on our screen. And, and you say one of the most important things is finding out what your genetic history is.
That's absolutely right. One of the single most important things that a woman or a man in their family can do is have a very detailed understanding of their family history. Not just their mothers, their fathers, and their siblings, but their grandparents, cousins, aunts, and uncles.
More susceptible if, say, it's the, your closest relative that has it?
Exactly. A first degree or a close relative like a mother, father, or a sibling really increase that risk if there's a history of breast cancer or ovarian cancer, especially if that cancer occurs premenopausally, before a woman goes through menopause or the change of life. But any ovarian cancer at any age, multiple incidences of breast or ovarian cancer, a history of male breast cancer in the family can really increase that risk. Race can also matter. Ashkenazi Jewish women, for example, are very susceptible to carrying the BRCA gene and an increased risk for breast and ovarian cancer.
Let's talk a little bit about the ovarian cancer and the oophorectomy. Talk about that a little bit.
Absolutely. Yeah, oophorectomy or salpingo oophorectomy is a fancy medical term for removal of the fallopian tubes and ovaries. We call it BSO or bilateral salpingo-oophorectomy for short. And basically that procedure is actually a very straightforward, very simple procedure that a woman can undergo in which small incisions are made in the abdomen, up to 1 to 3 tiny incisions called minimally invasive surgery, and the fallopian tubes and ovaries are removed at that time.
This is obviously a preventative measure. So is that considered an elective surgery then, not a necessary surgery?
That's a great question. When a risk of cancer is that high, it could certainly be considered indicated, and most insurance carriers are going to cover those procedures because it is considered medically necessary. We can reduce the risk of ovarian cancer by 97 to 100% with removal of the fallopian tubes and ovaries, but we have to choose the right timing in a woman's life to do that so that we don't cause more risks than benefits.
And certainly not do it before or, you know, they're considering they're having children.
That's correct.
You want to make sure that that window is not closed.
Absolutely. And so women who are still considering childbearing, especially up to the age of, 39 or 40, we follow those women very closely if we know that they have an increased risk of ovarian or fallopian tube cancer. But by age 39 or 40, that increase for ovarian cancer in women with the BRCA gene really increases sharply.
Holy cow.
So at that point, we do strongly recommend consideration of a risk-reducing surgery.
All right. Dr. Fader, thank you so much for coming
in. Thank you for having me,
Jen. Very nice.